María Barrios Armida.
María Barrios Armida, Public Communication Brand Manager, Spain.
Con Masters Internacionales.
Bachelor's degree with a lot of international masters in neurocommunication and leadership.
Expert
in political communication, neurocommunication and perception. She has worked for political leaders in Spain, Mexico, England and the US. Speaker, conferencist and teacher in several universities in Spain and business schools.
Buenas tardes.
Good afternoon.
Ahora vamos a tener
una charla. We are going to possibly have
técnicas, las charlas legales, las charlas sobre temas
not a technical legal conference that we are used to have.
Contenido.
But I think we are going to have a content that is worthy because it is going to reset our mindset in a way. Now that we are back before the after the pandemic, we are happy, you know, to be here again in person, little by little. But we still maintain a very, you know, communication that is really based on social media. Now we have clients and formats in a hybrid format, and clients and colleagues in a format hybrid.
De la pandemia anterior, estamos en
you know, we are still in the pandemic. We are in the middle of a weird situation. And this makes you think more about the topics of communication. And for those of you who were in her brief presentation, you know, I think those of you still want more. A lot of you have expressed that to us, and now you are going to enjoy the main course. Maria, the floor is yours. The pleasure is mine. Thank you very much, all of you. Thank you so much for the organization. Yesterday, I thanked the board, and today, I want to ask you for an applause, a round of applause for the technicians, the photographers, Claudia, Patricia, the sound guys that allow, you know, make this possible to be here. Thank you so much. You are so geniuses.
Estamos. Otra.
All right, so here I am again talking about neurocommunication. My conference for today, I have 59 minutes, 52 seconds.
La voy a dividir en dos.
I'm going to divide it in two parts, two blocks. First, we are going to talk about the 9 things that you have to have about neurocommunication, and then I'm going to go to a more practical aspect. The first axiom, when we talk about neurocommunication, when we talk about our brain, about your brains and your clients' brains, in the world, everybody has the same voice, especially now that we live in a globalized world with social media, but not all voices are worth the same. We see here a lot with children. I don't know how many of you have children here. Please raise your hands. Don't be shy. As you know, when children are very, very young, especially when they are young, mom and dad are like, wow. And whatever they say is, wow. Actually, sometimes they fight in college because my mom said and my dad said. Those parents have all the same voice, but not all voices are worth the same. When we talk about business, the business world, when we become adults, the same thing happens. And I suppose that a lot of you that are here, you know, you heard the speakers. And you say, well, I said that a long time ago, but your voice is not worth the same as the person that is sitting here. Why? Because you have not built the public image and the reputation. That is why public image is so important. So your voice can be differentiated from the rest. The second axiom. The brain, my brain, Marcelo's brain, everybody's brains here. They brains like simple things. We don't like complicated things. The brain wants you to make it easy for him, easy at the time of speaking, easy at the time of communicating. You have to make it easy at the time of creating a web page. Sometimes I see webs that are to die for. This is one of the worst web pages in the world. And it gives us clues about what you shouldn't do. When your brain looks at this page, it explodes. It gets disconnected. It says, like, what is this? There are many things that are of impact, and he doesn't know where to look, where to focus their attention. That's why not always more is better. The third axiom of the nine from the first block, we always make decisions and act based on feelings and emotions. Neurocommunication is based on this, on about what I am making you feel here today and also what you are making me feel as well. This is not something I say, and I say it too. This is said by an expert in topics of neurocommunication and perception, Antonio Damasio. I recommend you write down this name, his name, if you like this topic. He says, when we receive an external stimuli, yesterday we talked about stimuli that could be visual, it could be smells. When we receive an external stimulus, our brain sends an order to the body and the body reacts. What does that mean? That right now you are hearing my voice, you are looking at my nonverbal behavior, and your brain is doing an analysis of everything that you see. And maybe someday, I don't know, you know, you see somebody that was wearing a dotted dress and you hated that person. And now you look at me with a dotted dress and you already rejected me. This is something that is very complex. It's a very complex process that is created in the brain when you see something. For example, when I was young, my grandparents had a very big piece of land, and they only wanted me to play in the grass. Only when the lawn was mown. So when I heard the lawnmower and I smelled the recently cut grass, I knew that I was going to go out to play. Now that I am a lot older, I'm not going to tell you how old I am, but a lot older. When I passed by a place and I smelled the freshly cut grass, I smile. My brain learned to recognize that stimulus, and it's ingrained in my brain forever. So now when I smell the grass, I smile, not because I like the grass now, but because my brain remembers what I lived when I was a child. Yesterday we talked about Mickey Mouse, this little mouse, right? Let's take a look at the evolution of this little bug, how he had changed. All of these things that we are seeing here generate an emotion to us. The first mouse,
el último ratón, es mucho más abrazable.
It's a lot more, you know, it's not very likable. The last one is more huggable. The first one, your brain created a process of rejection to the first one and of appreciation of the last one simply by the stimulus that you are giving. That's how the brain works. The brain works based on emotions. That's why the easiest way of conquering the brain of your clients is by generating emotion to them.
Las emociones.
And who is the
te ha tocado.
Examen sobre queen of emotions? Come on, let's see.
Es la reina. Es decir, cuando yo, por ejemplo, me llega un cliente, ¿qué emoción?
For example, when I see a client, when I receive a client, what is the emotion that you want to transmit to their clients? What is it? You know, I want the clients to feel happy. I want them to fantasize. Which emotion do you think is the first one I work with?
Capacidad de resolver su problema.
The capacity to resolve their problems, maybe. Who else?
Pues.
Success.
Felicidad.
Happiness, maybe.
Nadie ha acertado todavía, pero por...
Nobody has given the right answer, but you're getting close. Confidence? Who said confidence? Please, let's give her a round of applause. What's your name? Lorena, please, an applause to Lorena, because yes, it is confidence. Like we saw in axiom number one, we all have the same voice, but not all voices are worth the same. Why? Because if you have not created your brand, your reputation created, people are not going to trust you. And if they don't trust you, they're not going to believe you. If they don't believe you, they're not going to buy from you. They're not going to vote for you. This is not something I said. This is something one of my teachers says, that confidence is the most important element at the time when we evaluate others. We are on axiom number 3 of 9, important things in neurocommunication that I need you to know before we go to the second phase. Confidence. Confidence is a process that, yes, it can take time, but our brain can decode things very quickly in the first impression. Here we have the things that can make a person
más
in the first impression can seem more trustworthy than others. People that smile look 65% more trustworthy than a person that comes to you and doesn't smile. So please smile a little.
El ritmo al hablar.
When you vary your tone or your rhythm when you talk,
parece más confiable.
Somebody seems more trustworthy. When you look at somebody in the eye, if I tell you how many times I've had to teach a client to look in the eyes of others, why? Because it's complicated. When they look at you directly in the eyes, it can seem a little bit defiant. Also, when it's overwhelming to look at somebody in the eye, look at this area, and it seems like you are looking at them directly. To give brief and rational answers, it makes us look 25% more trustworthy than a person that just expresses their motives. And please use an understandable language. I know you know a lot. You know, we're all attorneys, and we've been taught to talk, you know, law language from the first day that we studied Roman law. But the common person will lose your attention right away.
Como si pudieran,
I always let them, I always let my customers know that you need to talk in a way that anybody can understand you, from the person that works at the bakery up until the person that won the Nobel Prize. The brain likes easy things. You have to dress according to what you are. And to give you an example,
no recuerdo cuánto,
I don't remember how long ago, maybe a month ago, Queen Letizia, the Queen of Spain, she went to a country, and I'm sorry, I don't remember which country, for a cooperation trip. If you remember the country, please let me know, because I forgot. She went to Paraguay. Perfect. She was very heavily criticized in Paraguay and Spain. I don't know if the rest of the world as well, but she was very criticized because she got down, you know, she got off the plane because she was dressed as a helper, as an aide. And not because of that, not only because of that, it's that she went to a dinner, a gala, dressed with the vest, and then after that she was received by the authorities and she still had the vest. So when you are looking at a queen, when you are expecting to see a queen and you see a helper, you see the aide, that is disappointing. That happens to everybody. And you might be, you know, the smartest person in the room, but dress according to your role, according to your ranking, also according to your essence, because Bill Gates, who was, you know, one of the biggest leaders, he went to work in sneakers. He didn't dress according to his position, but he dressed according to his essence. If you want to be trustworthy, dress according to your position. We are all here human beings with our problems. I have problems and you have problems, and each one of us is good at something. There are people that have a lot of inferiority complexes, and they try to bring other people down. And at the end, you know, we're not all good at everything, but we are good at something. So if you want to be trustworthy, have a nice, be kind to others. Maybe you are able to teach the Queen of Spain a lesson. Maybe you can teach her something. Call people by their names. And this is very hard. You have a lot of rules to help you remember the name of the person that you are introduced to. It's hard for me to learn names. And I know a lot of people that are not good with names. What are you going to do? You have to work on that. Why? Because the brain of the people that is listening to you loves that you call them by their name. When you hear your name in the mouth of others, that is the sound that the brain likes the most. Who remembers Sejano? Anybody? Do you know who this Roman man was? If anyone of you raises your hand, I leave.
Que no vale buscarlo en Google.
It doesn't count if you Google it.
¿Os acordáis de Sejano?
Well, I'm very happy that you don't remember Sejano, because Sejano was sentenced in the Roman times to the damnatio memoriae. What is this weird stuff? At the time, it wasn't weird. When you were really, really bad, they eliminated your name from everywhere. It would disappear. They would just erase your name from everywhere. Christina told us before to the right to images. He didn't have the right to images or anything. He was just removed from statues. His name was erased from history because he, traitor Tejano, but that is something else. The name, when any one of you pronounces my name, hello, Maria, how are you? These areas in my brain get highlighted. There was a study in Jersey University. When you know somebody and you want to conquer them, you know, you want to have them as a client, call them by their name. We are on number 4 out of 9 axioms. I have 47 minutes, so I'm good with time.
A ver, señoras y señores.
So, ladies and gentlemen, if you want to be trustworthy, we saw it before with Emicadi, you need
claramente
to speak clearly without being very pompous or very fancy.
Personas que transmitan una información relevante.
And you need to be able to transmit relevant information.
Your
client's brain is only interested if it's relevant. If not, they'll leave. Some of you in your talks before, you know, you had topics that you liked more and some others that you didn't like as much. If it wasn't relevant to you, you just erased it. And the fact that it's relevant for you, it doesn't mean that it's relevant for your clients. You keep this in mind. What you like, I use what you like to create a reputation and an image. But like I said yesterday, you need to speak to the brain of the person that you are talking to. And what you think needs to be interesting to them. Because the fact that you like it doesn't mean that it's going to be relevant or useful to that person. Are you familiar with this person, with this man? Winston?
Pues el señor Churchill
con well, Mr. Churchill, with his tobacco, he loved to paint. And he loved it to talk about paintings. Whenever he had meetings at his house with artists from all over the world, at the parliament, he didn't talk about anything related to painting because he knew that something that was interesting to him was not interesting or relevant for the English population. So talk to your customers about what they want to talk about. 5 out of 9, and then we go to block number 2.
A vuestro cerebro, al de
your brain and your clients' brains, your children's brains, your parents' names, brains, I'm sorry, they love odd numbers. They like odd numbers. Later on, we're going to talk about it. The Three Little Pigs, the Three Musketeers, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. They like, brains like odd numbers. When in doubt, always choose an odd number. Number two is the number of equilibrium. Number two is the number of division. We are going to talk about this later on, but always an odd number. When you are going to buy, you see it. If you see something that is $100 and something that is $99, and we see, ooh, it's so cheap. It's just pure marketing. Why? Because your brain likes odd numbers.
Todos los seres humanos, salvo uno.
Every human being except for one, that I knew somebody that works in mindfulness,
esto vivimos.
The rest of us live 80% of our time whether in the past or in the future.
¿Esto qué significa?
What does this mean at the time of neurocommunicate that our clients?
Que plantear el problema.
We need to talk about the problem, but we also have to give them the solution.
A esos dos lados donde siempre están.
Let's talk to both sides because they're always thinking about those both sides. Like, what sense does it make for you to talk about a problem without giving them the solution? You lay out the problem, and then you give them the solution later on to be able to bring the loyalty of that customer.
Como el mío.
Your brain, just like mine, cooks slowly.
Es comidas de mamá.
Like the big meals from your mother.
Sobre todo cuando leemos.
We see this especially when we read.
¿Qué?
Why? Because a message is effective when it leaves you thinking about it, when it creates an emotion. When your client leaves your office And the client goes to their home and they turn off the light because they're sleeping and they think about what you told them. You have won. You succeeded. When we read a book,
sabemos que nos gusta.
We know that we like it. When all of a sudden, at that time, when you close it, you keep thinking about it.
Nuestro cerebro se cuece a
fuego. Our brain cooks slowly. Try for your customers, your lovers, your children to keep thinking about that phrase that you said.
Con un silencio.
That usually happens with a silence. That usually starts with a silence. One of the biggest mistakes that I have found with the customers that I've had is that they know a lot about about one topic, but they don't say it. It's like, what? If you don't, you know, if you don't tell people things, people don't know them. If you want something, you have to ask for it. When we, like we said at the, like we saw at the beginning, the brain like things easy. Talk to your customers and don't leave anything behind. Don't, you know, whatever you don't say is like it doesn't exist. If you don't say it, it doesn't exist. And if it doesn't exist, your customer doesn't know it. If you don't write down here, don't push this button under any condition, I can assure you that I will go and press the red button because, you know, on top of everything, we really like the color red. And less is always more. What does the speech in Gettysburg and the Ten Commandments have in common? They have only one thing in common. Who can guess?
Wow, así que no. Una sola cosa en común.
They only have one thing in common, Matías.
Así que lo debes de saber.
You saw my talk, so you must know it.
El discurso negativo, sí, lo que no conoces. Con los 10 mandamientos.
Yeah, but what does the speech of Gettysburg have in common with the Ten Commandments?
Mira, te hubieras ganado una cena si hubieras estado todo incluido. ¿Qué significa discurso de Gettysburg? Depende de la traducción que cojáis, pero son 300 palabras.
It depends on the translation. It's 300 words. Lincoln used 300 words.
Según la versión que...
And the Ten Commandments, according to whatever version you use, are 100 and some... words. They are brief, basically. Yes. Our brain likes easy things. They like odd numbers, they like relevant things, and they like things that are brief. And with that, I'm going to go to the second phase, 20 minutes. I'm a genius.
La segunda fase. Todo lo que os he dicho, estos 9 axiomas,
everything that I've told you in these 9 axioms, are going to be useful to work on neurocommunication. And now we are going to see 7 elements that are going to help you seduce your customers. I said this yesterday. I told you, communication is not about being the best speakers in the world. For some of you, today I'm going to be a good speaker. For others, I'm going to be a total disaster and I should go home. And for others, I am a genius that should receive the Nobel Prize of Literature. It's not... you don't have to be the best, but you have to be unforgettable in whatever you do. But you have to be unforgettable in your field to be, you know, you need to be remembered. This is how I build the reputation on somebody. I based on their essence, their identity. I, you know, take a look at what their audience is. I generate an opinion. And after some time have passed, we have the reputation. And I could summarize this. Because I work with a person or a company, I work in them in being, in appearances and to do. Why? Because none of you that are here, none of you here are owners of your images like we saw that yesterday, but we are responsible for it. Today, I'm giving you stimulus and based on that, you are going to generate an opinion about me. And based on that, if everyone shares the same opinion, I'm going to generate a reputation. We saw that yesterday for those of you that weren't here yesterday at the talk. And for those of you that were, let's see if you were paying attention. How long does the brain take to make a judgment about somebody? 1/10 of a second. Perfect. You are geniuses. This is John Barr. He said it. There is an ad. I think it's about a car. I don't remember what brand it is. That always says 2 seconds, 2 seconds. Well, it's not right. It's 2/10 of a second. And this that I didn't explain yesterday,
de nuestros
comes from our ancestors in the from the cavemen. When our ancestors used to see a lion or a mammoth or somebody from another tribe, they had to do a very quick analysis to know whether or not this person was going to attack them and destroy them, or if they were, you know, a colleague and they could cooperate together. This has to be quick because their lives depended on it. We have evolved, but it's still ingrained in our brains. Basically, it's still in the limbic brain, the reptilian brain. This is why it is so important to generate a first good impression. And not only physically speaking, but when we are in social media, the slide, we take 0.2 seconds. And this is the difference between somebody looking at a post or not looking at it. The first impression, like we saw yesterday, it doesn't always have to be the right one. It's about you leaving the door open for your future client to go in, or either you close it. This is why it's so important that you have to communicate well the first time. That is why it's important for you to speak well the first time, to have a very good web page that you know how to summarize, that you know how to reach your audience, for your social media to be interesting, to say relevant things, and not something that is interesting only to you. Most of our decisions are taken through our eyes, like we saw yesterday about coffee. This is obvious. And there are people that tell me, well, I don't care about these things because I am a genius in what I do. Well, it's wonderful that you're a genius, but maybe you don't look like a genius. And if you don't look like it, it's not good for you to be a genius, only for you and your ego and your family's ego. This is a cupcake or a muffin? This is a muffin that can cost maybe 80 cents, and a cupcake can cost 80 cents, and a muffin can cost, you know, 10 euros. This is life, and you need to use it at your advantage. I'm giving you the magic trick. Use it when you dress. You have to dress according to what you want to transmit and according to your ranking, to your position. And the way you dress influences what people are going to think about you in 2/10 of a second. And if you don't believe it, I'm sorry, but you are already losing that superpower. You can transmit either accessibility or authority with the way you dress. I was working for 3 years as a general director in a government in Valencia. And when I used to go into the office in the morning, the security guard used to tell me, well, you have a very big meeting today.
Sí. Porque necesitaba transmitir autoridad.
And I was like, why do you say that? He's like, well, what, by the way you dress. Yes, because I needed to transmit authority. Sometimes I needed to transmit approachability only with one stimulus, clothing. Use it to your advantage. This is Mr. Obama. I don't know if you can see the image clearly or if it's very pixelated. This photograph, what did he want to transmit? Well, not Mr. Obama, but his team. What did they want to transmit with this picture? That he walks a lot, I heard. What did they want to make us think? Humility, humbleness.
Obama tenía esos zapatos en su casa.
Do you think Obama had those shoes in his house? Accessibility.
Le prestaron esos zapatos.
Somebody.
Que tuvo que además.
One of the chairs, one of the chairmen's lent him these shoes. That's why they made those holes. It's completely staged, but it transmits something. Welcome to the world of images. Use it for your own advantage. Angela Merkel, she has her own image with different grades, different flavors, different colors. How do you know if you have a good public image?
Porque os pueden imitar a la señora Merkel.
Because people can imitate you. If I want to dress tomorrow as Mrs. Merkel, I just have to dress like that. She has a perfectly designed public image, and that is just talking about image. Let's see in Amsterdam. Let's see what they say. You don't have to only dress with what you like, but you have to dress with what looks good for you. This is not me saying it. This is the government of Amsterdam.
Lo quitaron hace años.
Yeah, it's a little strong. They removed it a long time ago. Visual stimuli, even your sunglasses communicate something. To create a public image and a reputation through neurocommunication tools, your appearance is the easiest thing to change. It is very easy, very simple to change your appearance. It usually takes me 2 sessions. Let's take a look at how the image changes with eyeglasses and no eyeglasses. Authority, accessibility, more approachability, less approachability. What do you want to transmit? Play with stimulus. This is about playing. Unless you're Vladimir Putin and it doesn't really, you don't really care. But if you're not Putin, use the stimulus to your advantage. Those of you that gave me cards, I am going to explore all of your social media today, and the first thing I'm going to look at is your profile picture, and that is going to transmit something to me. If you look to your right, like Emmanuel Macron, looks at the right to the people that he looks at. He looks at the future, at the hope, at the illusion. And our brain processes that in 0.2 seconds. And your clients, when they explore you, when they look at you, like I'm going to do tonight, they do that same process. Can you please use those tools according to what you want to transmit? Don't leave it to your taste. Do you want your customer to think that you are a person in the future that is going to solve their issues? Post a picture looking to your right. Post a picture with people. If you want to, you know, be seen as somebody that is more nostalgic, more reflective, look to the other side, look at another side with your profile pictures. But it's not enough with being. You can be, like we said before, you can be the biggest genius in the Mediterranean or in the Pacific. But you have to look like it. Who is this lady? Or was this lady? Pompeya.
O iba de romanos. ¿Alguien sabe quién era Pompeya?
Anybody know who Pompeya was?
La mujer del César, perfecto.
The wife of Caesar. César. The wife of Mr. Julio Caesar. Pompeya had a friend.
De nada más que no fueron amigos. Un amigo se llamaba Publio Clodio.
A friend called Publio Clodio. And when Pompeya was married to Caesar, Caesar had 3 wives. Even though the most important woman in his life was his mother, but that is another story. When he was married to Pompeya, he was still not in the military. He was not involved in those topics. And actually, Mario, that was supposedly an uncle of his, enrolled him as a chief in Roman religion because the chief of Roman religion couldn't touch a sword. And because of that, he would never be a leader in Rome. That's another story. So we have Julius Caesar married to Pompeya, and she had a friend called Publio Clodio, and Julius Caesar was the representative of the church in Roma, and the representative of the church in Roma had to celebrate every year a very big party that was expected by everybody in the honor of a goddess, a female goddess. There was only one condition in that party, and it's that you couldn't have any men. So they would all leave. And they would all leave, all of the women. So what happened? Publio Clodio went into the party. He dressed as a woman. He went into the party and he got caught. It caused such a scandal in Rome that was really big. What happened? That Caesar got divorced from his woman. And Pompeya said to him, I had no idea about this. You know, Publio got into the party. I'm innocent. Why are you divorcing me? And he said, Caesar looked at her and said, because the woman of Caesar not only has to be honest, she also has to appear honest. It's the same with you. It's not enough with being good in what you do. You have to seem good at what you do. This is a real case. She was not one of my clients, but at the end, she called me when she was already in the mess. I don't know what happens later on. I'm sorry, recently, everybody calls me when they have a problem. She was an image consultant. She changed the image of a psychologist. She was a psychologist. But because they only changed the physical appearance, the physical image, after 1 month, she went back to her natural essence that was this.
¿Y qué pasó?
So what happened?
que perdió toda su credibilidad.
She lost all of her credibility. She lost her reputation because clients were expecting one thing and they received another thing.
Si me meto en que tú no puedes parecer y dejar otra cosa.
You can't look like something and then be something else. You have to be coherent always. And the physical appearance is very important. What does she do? What does this lady do?
Luis Alejandro, ¿a qué se dedica?
Luis Alejandro, what does she do?
No te pongas colorado, no te pongas colorado.
Please don't blush, don't blush.
Bueno, no le vamos a poner un compromiso. ¿Y si te digo que no?
Well, let's not put him in the spot.
No me va. Nos hemos quedado aquí. Ahora la que se va a poner colorada voy a ser yo. Puede ser un mensaje del universo. No puedo cambiar. No puedo cambiar.
Maybe this is a message from the universe. I can't change the slide.
Hay alguien que quiere que sigamos hablando de esta señorita.
Anybody wants us to? There's somebody that wants us to keep talking about this lady.
Si le cambiamos su imagen y su aspecto.
If we change her image and her aspect, she's going to transmit something else to us. Why? Because we changed one stimulus, in this case, the visual stimulus.
Prostituta.
And we can make somebody that in this case looks like a prostitute, clearly.
Ah.
Two.
Os voy a dejar con la tensión, ¿eh?
I'm going to leave you guessing.
Bueno. En este caso era una...
Anyways, in this case, she was a widow with 5 children.
Hemos cambiado un estímulo.
We changed one stimulus.
Eso en una web.
Let's take a look at what that can do in a web page.
Estímulos y aparece la viuda.
When you start changing the stimulus, now we have the widow here. What do we do?
El poder de la imagen, ¿no?
Now you see the power of the image. What does this person do? What does he do? Let's see, Luis Alejandro again.
Casi habéis acertado. Esta vez es.
You almost got it right.
Aplicaciones para iPhone.
He works on applications for iPhones.
Bueno, vamos a poner.
And what does this one do?
Para mujeres. En este caso.
Let's also be good to the women. Let's see, what does he do?
A saquear el Congreso. No sé quién ha dicho eso, pero ha sido buenísimo. ¿Quién ha sido? Pues bueno, este hombre es un pastor.
He's a pastor. He's a missionary pastor.
Estímulo.
I changed one stimulus. Imagine what we can do, not only with the physical aspect, but also when we talk about speech, when we talk about effective communication, when we talk about messages to transmit, when we talk about web pages of social media. If you are, but you don't look like it.
Si eres.
If you are a genius but you don't look like it, you're not going to get not even one customer because you're not going to have access to them. If you look like something but you are not that, your image is going to blow up. If you are and you look like it but you don't act like it, they're going to eat you up. And, you know, a lot of people that are even more prepared than you are going to come and take you out. This is what happens in 1 minute in social media, only in social media. And here we are talking about communication. And we leave that to, you know, randomly. Let's look at what happens in social media. We all have the same voice, but not all the voices are worth the same. So what do you do to have more recognition in your field? You need to speak to your audience. I said this yesterday, I say it today, I will say it tomorrow until you learn it. My mother used to repeat things to me 80 times and she would say, Mary, I'm going to repeat it to you until you learn it. The same thing here. Talk to your audience. Don't talk to the world in general. But for that, you have to, first of all, examine yourself to know who you are, what do you want, who your audience is. Who you are talking to, what does your audience need? Do you know that? What motivates them? What are they looking for?
¿Qué buscan?
What are they looking for? When I have to prepare an electoral campaign, we base ourselves in what is hurtful for them and what they want.
¿Qué motiva a
what motivates your client to look for you.
Chacado, ponérselo fácil, que sabéis que al cerebro le gustan las cosas.
Make it easy for them. You know the brain likes easy things. Make communication based on those things.
Upa.
What is hurtful for them or what worries them? About image, give them a problem, but lay out the problem, but also communicate the solution in social media, in articles, in congresses, in talks. Do you want to be an expert on that topic? Talk only about that topic. When I started creating my personal brand and my posterior public image and reputation, I centered myself in something that I was passionate about and that I'm still passionate about, which is nonverbal communication. I love it. I studied in Stanford University, and then I studied with a psychologist called Paul Ekman, talking about micro expressions. I don't know if you know about him. And I said very obsessed about that topic because... And that's why my boyfriends don't last, because I can very easily see when they are lying. What happened? I focused on one topic, but that didn't give me any revenue, any money. So I made a study. I saw who I was talking to, what motivated them, what they needed. And I realized that nonverbal communication was an excuse for people to be able to communicate better. And now I am an expert in neurocommunication because I made some modifications. You also have to do the same to see what your client needs and make it easy for them. You have to make your voice rise from the rest without fooling anybody.
Pero no.
Because if you look like something but you are not that, your image is going to fall.
No mintáis.
Do not lie. You don't have to be the best.
Las personas que
you have to be people that get to other people with emotions. But don't lie, please.
Con reputaciones destrozadas por mentiras, por intentar.
I've had clients that came to me with destroyed reputations because they lied, because they wanted to be something that they weren't. You can change public image. Let's take a look at this Australian fugitive. He also wanted his image to be changed because he didn't like it, but that's something else. Don't lie. Give your best image without lying, because in life, as in communication, everything is about perception. And here we're not lying. We are just taking a scene. Or do you think influencers are really that good to just give their best image without lying?
Es la misma fila, la misma
perception. This is the same line. It's the same, but it's not the same. We change the perspective.
El sentido completo de lo que estamos viendo.
And we completely change the sense of what we are seeing. This image that you see here now, I don't remember where it was. I don't remember if it was in Holland, because a newspaper published the image on top, because they were saying some people were not being compliant with the measures of anti-COVID. The real picture was the picture at the bottom.
Los medios de comunicación, esto es miente que algo queda. Pero al final es todo cuestión de percepción.
At the end, it's all about perception.
Siempre cuestión de percepción.
Everything is about perception, always.
Seis.
Number six.
Ya acabo, ¿eh? Voy a
20. I'm almost done.
Sexta idea que necesito.
Sixth idea that I need you to keep in your heads to have a good neurocommunication.
La importancia.
We've seen the importance of image, the importance of knowing the public you are talking to, the importance of creating your character. But if you don't use the right words, none of this is useful. Words have superpowers, and you don't know how much. It's not the same,
yo soy Antoñito.
You know, to have Antoñito and say, oh, I am Antoñito, I am an attorney for intellectual property.
María Pilar.
It's not the same as, you know,
hola, María Pilar.
To have Antonio say, hello, María Pilar.
Tiempo juntos.
I want you and I to stop time together tonight. So María Pilar is going to say, oh, I love you. The difference here is that words can have power. The same thing happened with communication. I was working for 3 years in a company for corporate communication, and I used to say to my clients all the time, I don't do copies, I do poetry. I sell music. I don't do copies. Words change everything. They change the meaning of everything. What are the three words? We already saw one, which is the name, but what are the three words that the brain likes the most?
¿Sí? ¿Quién ha dicho sí?
Yes, who said yes?
No, pero podría ser. Sara, la quinta. Por favor.
Please. No.
Gracias.
Thank you. No.
Bueno, le gusta mucho el gracias, pero no. La palabra tú, hablar de
the word you.
A la persona, cercanía.
To talk face to face.
Darle la solución.
Closeness. To talk face to face. To give them the solution. Why or why I'm going to do something. When you lay out the problem, the brain says, okay, yes, great. But when on top of that you give them the solution, the brain gets highlighted like a Christmas tree.
Y cualquier verbo de acción positiva.
And any verb of positive action. We like positive things. We just went through a pandemic. We are tired of problems. We want positive things. We want to communicate positively. Don't tell me no. Tell me why yes. Tell me why. You and I are going, tonight are going to do, we're going to achieve, we are going to conquer the world. And if you could see at your brain in a screen,
como en Navidad. Esto es,
it gets highlighted like in Christmas. Let's take a look at the difference on a phrase. The government asks or the government demands.
Es que no es lo mismo.
It's not the same. And all we did was change a verb.
Y nos vamos al maravilloso mundo de LinkedIn.
Now we go to the wonderful world of LinkedIn.
Gusta, por cierto.
This is the network that I dislike the most, by the way.
Este post.
And we have this post written by an expert in institutional relationships from MAPFRE. I don't know if you know MAPFRE. It's a Spanish insurance company.
Aquí en el otro lado del mundo. Fijaros, esto lo ve el cerebro y el cerebro.
Your brain takes a look at this, and your brain says, "I am so bored. I don't know where to look. There are too many stimuli," and your brain gets disconnected.
Solo
be mindful of words. It's not just what the words mean, but visually how we place them.
Aquí está hablando de un diálogo social en positivo.
He is talking about positive social dialogue.
Nuestro cerebro.
And he uses colors that put your brain to sleep because that doesn't transmit anything positive. And this is not me saying it. It's every expert in neuromarketing saying it.
Era un señor que presumía de ser consultor de comunicación.
So here I, you know,
publicación.
I hid his name because he presumed to be an expert in communication.
Hemos desconectado todos.
What do we do here? Did any one of you read the first phrase?
Segunda.
Maybe, but nobody went past the second phrase. And maybe he used very good words, but it's really messy. The format is very messy. For example, in my publications, especially in the emails, I try not to go over three paragraphs because I know number three is, you are crazy about the number three. So I use this. It's a superpower. You can use it as well.
Esta es una publicación mía.
This is a publication from me from a long time ago. Just visually, things change. Your brain gets a breath of air. You have paragraphs, you have three ideas. There are bullet points.
A mi equipo, ¿saben? Que si me mandan.
My team knows that if they send me an email like this, I don't read it. And I just ask them, give me a summary.
Ponme negrita, cursiva y subrayados, y párrafos separados.
And please separate the paragraphs, use bullet points.
Más facilidad.
Use cursives.
Esto se ha vuelto a estropear.
Make it easier for people.
Ya estaba terminando, así que tampoco pasa nada. Mirad, la comunicación, ayer lo vimos.
Like we saw yesterday. Communication is going to be the difference in what we are going to do, what you are going to do from now on.
Comunicación, yo no os aseguro un éxito.
If you have good communication, I don't guarantee you success because I can't. But I can assure you that if you maintain strategic communication, you are going to see some differences because that voice that is not being heard today is going to be heard because you are going to start being experts in a topic, in a subject. And that, you can do that through emotions, through speaking to people on what they need to hear, through generating trust. And in strategic communication, like we saw at the beginning, it's not just about appearances, which is the easiest thing to manage. It's about saying something relevant to people, and it's especially about having a clear message. I said this at the beginning.
Ahora se ha ido. Mira, una playa como la de ahora. Lo he dicho al inicio.
I said that at the beginning, And I'm going to say this at the end. It's not about being the best.
Siempre va a haber alguien mejor.
There's always going to be somebody that's better than you. Always. There's always going to be somebody better than you and somebody worse than you. But it's about
un buen pozo.
Being different from the rest.
Cuando yo tengo, me viene un cliente nuevo.
When I have a new customer, I always ask them, how do you think others see you? And he says, X, Y, Z. Then we do studies and we see that that's not real. They have usually a completely wrong image on how others see us and how they see themselves. For example, when I work with a political candidate, I always reunite with their team to see how they look at him. And the image that their team has, it's usually not correspondent to the image that their wives or husband have about them. And it's usually the same as the image that the voters have. Sometimes we have more than one audience. Sometimes you have to talk to a lot of people. Sometimes even you have to be a different product of yourself. But it's very important that as of this talk, all of the communication that we do to whoever is focused on giving that person or those people what they need, on using the tools that I have given you in neurocommunications for yourselves to know, for example, if in a meeting you need to transmit trustworthiness or accessibility. You know, so you don't post something on Twitter because you want it. But why? What am I going to get with this? From now on, it's not about changing your logo because you like it more or you like it less. It's about launching a message. It's about communicating. Start communicating and stop informing. Like we saw yesterday, it's not the same. It's not the same to just, you know, blurt out information. What for? What is that going to teach us? You need to excite people, communicate, and transmit your best image all the time.
Si os tuviera que dar un consejo,
if I had to give you a piece of advice, only one.
Mira, voy a acabar 10 minutos antes.
I'm going to finish 10 minutes before. If instead of 1 hour,
pitch,
I had to do an elevator pitch, or, you know, if I only had 1 minute, if someone asks me, Maria, give me just one phrase.
Una buena reputación.
How do I get good reputation? How do I generate my the image of my brand? I will tell them the golden rule. There's one golden rule in life. At least for me, and for a lot of people that do this as well, kindness. If you want to achieve a good image, a good reputation, treat other people the same way you want to be treated. And with that, you have guaranteed success. We saw yesterday about the smile. Let's see if you were paying attention. What's the one thing in common between 2 ounces of chocolate, a smile, and 10 million pounds in cash? Do you remember? They generate the same pleasure to the brain. Please smile. Be kind. These are the muscles that are used with a genuine smile and a fake smile. So when we have the mask, even when we have the mask, we knew who was genuinely smiling and who wasn't.
Se sonríe con la boca.
You smile with your lips.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen,
segundos, deciros, como decía Maquiavelo, que
like Maquiavelo used to say, very few people are going to see what we are, but a lot of people are going to see what we look like. Questions, if you want to have questions now, anybody has a question, this is the time. If you have any complaints, go to the president. Please. Take this opportunity because when he was in the club brainstorm, one of the most interesting areas of her interaction, of her participation, was the interaction with the entire team because we had new topics. If we had a shy group that is not characteristic of a CP, I'm going to propose role play. If you have any questions, do you have any questions? No questions.
Yeah.
Oh, we have a question.
José. Ya va el micrófono.
Hola, gracias.
Si Hello, thank you.
Nosotros pensar.
If we could think that we are authentic and that we project and we try to project that authenticity, is it possible to change, to transform ourselves to what we want to be? Or should we try to stay within our essence? Image is dynamic, it changes. It changes the stimulus, like we saw with the pictures. We changed a visual stimulus and automatically I changed the perception that you have. Image is dynamic. We're not always going to look the same because consequences in life can change. For example,
chica, Miley Cyrus.
Miley Cyrus.
No rompas más mi pobre corazón. Bueno, no me acuerdo. Miley Cyrus era una chica.
Miley Cyrus was a Disney girl. You remember, very Disney, very nice. And all of a sudden, she turned into this rebel without cause, and she started having all kinds of piercings and her clothing. Everything changed, and she changed. Why? Because she became an adult. And now she's not a Disney girl anymore. She was not an adolescent, not a teenager, and she had to keep selling records. You can change your image, and it's a mistake not to change your image. You have to analyze. Today, I gave a conference of 1 hour, and I told you all of this have a lot of analysis. Every time I have a client, every month and a half, I analyze, I reassess to see how their audience is doing. A lot of statistics, a lot of data. This is not from intuition. I analyze more Excel sheets than writing speeches. It changes. Your audience changes, your needs changes, and you have to change your strategy, but respecting what you are. At the end, Miley Cyrus was a Disney girl because she was a wonderful little girl, but then she transformed into a rebel without cause. What are we going to do? But she was still authentic in spite of that change. I don't know if I answered the questions. You always have to analyze the public, not at yourself, at your audience. And if they change, you have to change.
Gracias, aquí estoy.
Thank you.
Margarita.
Allá atrás. Fondo Sur. Hola, Fondo Sur.
Hola, gracias. ¿Qué tal?
Thank you.
Si está Margarita, adelante, me espero.
No, no, Martín, dale.
Bien, gracias.
Usen la amabilidad.
Thank you.
Me gusta.
Please be kind. Thank you.
Martín, después Margarita.
Gracias. ¿En qué forma incide en tu
In what way?
La ciencia, el entorno cultural en el que te desenvuelves?
In what way the cultural environment you live in is going to modify neuroscience?
A calificar o te refiero a alguien, voy a exagerar un poco, tal vez con un síndrome de esquizofrenia, para ser aceptado.
How do you take a person that has, for example, schizophrenia and make them be accepted? How all of this...
Pregunta porque no te he entendido muy bien el tema de la esquizofrenia.
Es decir, la primera parte realmente es el entorno social en el que nos movemos para...
The social environment that you live in, how does it affect how you connect, how you communicate? Now, of course, you have extreme conditions like schizophrenia. Maybe somebody that has that wants to project something...
...percibido bien o incorrectamente a pesar de los esfuerzos que él haga por ser aceptado, digamos, o percibido.
How good is this person going to be perceived in spite of their efforts? Well, this is not an easy topic. If you think creating a good reputation and a good image is easy, it's very mistaken. This is an octopus. It has many legs. Martin has brought a very interesting topic. He's talking about a mental disease like schizophrenia. How does that affect your credibility or how does that affect somebody? You would have to work on this person a lot. You would need to analyze this person a lot. It's not very difficult, but you have to work on it because if you already have something negative to your environment that is like a roadblock for that credibility, you have two options, either leave it to chance or going with a professional that controls your stimulus and the communication that you launch. That will be a very interesting topic for study. I used to work on communication for Alzheimer. And it's very close to me now because she has Alzheimer's at 62 years old. Now she's 72, so I am very involved with that topic.
Muchísimo rechazo.
And I found a lot of rejection at the time of communicating mental health topics.
Desde la pena, que era el sentimiento que me encontré.
From sadness, which is the feeling that I encounter the most in people, and I also, you know, use that to my advantage.
Entonces comenzamos
to lack of knowledge. So we started using communication to teach people, in this case society, about what does it mean to have, for example, Alzheimer's or any type of disease. It is a word that takes a longer time. You have to plan for longer, but it's possible, but you have to work on it a lot more.
Margarita, después Juan.
No me quites el puesto, no.
Los que están por el fondo, por favor.
Te digo, amablemente.
No, Margarita, ahora.
Yeah, Margarita, now it's your turn.
No, María, tú hablas de que siempre hay gente mejor.
You say that there's always somebody better than you, professionally, or, you know, worse than you. What do you think?
Hay mucha gente, muchos profesionales.
About, you know,
ponen por escrito, ponen en sus redes.
Publicity from professionals in their web pages, their social media saying, I'm the best, this is the best, I'm the only one, I'm the best. What do you think of those people, of that type of promotion? I don't like that type of promotion, but yes, that is a marketing strategy.
Alguien me dice, yo soy el mejor en mi campo.
When somebody tells me I'm the best in my field, I always tell them, well, okay, good for you.
Vanidad mata.
And I've always thought that being vain kills people other than anything else, more than anything else.
Muy alta. A mí no me gusta.
But if you have a very high self-esteem, that's very good. I don't like it, but yes, it is a marketing strategy. If you're the best, you buy the best. For example, this ring is very, very good. Yes, they fool a lot of people. What happens? When you look like something but you are not, and you say you're the best, and you receive this ring that is supposed to be the best that there is, and it's really not, then your image is going to fall.
Pero si no,
if you're the best, then yes, I'm going to sell it. But if you're not the best, then you need to be more humble. And yes, maybe you can have fame for 1 minute. There are people that want to be famous for one people. And there are people that want to fool a lot of people. Well, that is their marketing strategy. I prefer to have loyal customers.
Técnicas y tácticas.
With techniques and tactics.
So, bueno, gracias, María, por tu...
Thank you, María.
Que nos diste a todos. La pregunta es construir una imagen, pero obviamente que hablamos desde el punto de vista profesional, porque si estamos construyendo una imagen para...
To be able to build an image professionally.
¿Es así eso?
Right, if we try to build an image, it's only for professional purposes, right? Because if we try to change our image for our daily life, we are going to lose our essence, right?
A ver, dar una respuesta a esto es complicado porque...
It is very complicated because I need to analyze this globally because there are many layers to this. I always like to do hybrids.
¿Por qué? Porque los profesionales al...
Why? Because at the end of the day, professionals are people. In my social media...
Primera vez que me pongo un bikini en 10 años.
I've put three pictures in bikini. Why? Because we are human beings. So people like to see the human being behind the professional.
Sonar.
Meaning the personal image, it's very linked to the professional image.
¿Contrario?
And whoever says the opposite is lying. And also, it is very hard.
Equipo llevamos ahora 15...
In my team, we are managing 15 social media for different politicians and other clients. It is very hard to trace the line, to trace the border.
Mis clientes políticos siempre les digo.
To my political clients, I always tell them, people is going to vote for the person, not the politicians. Make them get to know you,
pero,
you know, with some measures, but you would have to analyze.
Lo mejor es,
to me, the best thing is for the professional to also, you know, to make it seem like, you know, they are also human beings. And you ask me something that I always get asked in regards to social media, and that is, do you have to be in every social media? You have people that are in every social media and they post the same thing everywhere. And I always tell them, no, you have to be in the social media where your audience is. I barely post anything in LinkedIn.
Well,
I don't use it because my audience is not there.
¿Y qué pasa? Aquí rompo con LinkedIn. final se trata de qué es lo que quiere tu público.
At the end, you have to work on what your audience wants to see.
Profesional.
And those accounts that are excessively professional.
¿Qué hacen?
With those companies.
Esas infografías que son todas las mismas.
That do all the same information. They don't have a soul.
Construir también la imagen en base a la esencia de la persona.
I also build the image with the essence of the person.
Empresas.
The soul of the person.
Amigo. Después.
I have a lot of companies.
Empresas de comunicación.
That come to work for me.
A su esencia.
After working with many companies that have taken the soul.
Fábricas.
Out of their company.
Mostrar sin miedo la persona.
They have lost their essence, so you have to show the person behind the professional.
Hola, María.
Hello, María.
WhatsApp.
What about WhatsApp?
Tipo de mensaje.
Do you have any tips on the types of messages, audios, profiles?
Tema de WhatsApp.
The same thing. I will have to analyze what do you want it for, and I'd have to analyze the types of messages that you are transmitting right now. I love WhatsApp as communication, and I was a pioneer in Spain in communicating through WhatsApp. Why? Because everybody has WhatsApp. And again, you have to be where your audience is, but it has to be brief, concise, and clear about audios. I'm a very big fan of audios. The voice. I am very big fan of radio. When I work with a client before going to the newspapers, even, you know, it's really expensive. I tell them, go to radio, use it. Maybe later on we can talk about more concrete cases and I give you more tips, but you have to be brief, you have to be clear and concise, and also WhatsApp for professionals. If you don't have WhatsApp for professionals, use the status, WhatsApp status. People look at them a lot. I didn't say this before.
Un cotilla dentro. Es decir, nos encanta ver lo que hacen los demás.
We all love to take a look at what other people is doing. We love to watch WhatsApp statuses.
Tenemos
one more question over here.
Una derivación, digo, primero, gracias, excelente charla.
Thank you, excellent talk, Mary.
En cuanto a las redes,
in regards to social media,
si es recomendable,
is it recommendable
deslindar los perfiles para
to unlink the profiles? For example, I use Facebook
personales
for personal siempre topics almost all the time.
Personales, pudieras
Instagram for personal stuff, maybe for some professional things. Twitter only for professional things. What do you think about that? I would have to analyze it. You don't transmit the same message to everyone in the same way. You shouldn't communicate the same in Twitter, in Instagram, and Facebook. That's a mistake. Sometimes I do it for convenience because I don't have a lot of time, but I would have to analyze. I would have to look at you. I would have to see you. I would have to do a lot of calculations and analyses. I would have to do a follow-up and analysis. Look at the feedback from your audience. But at the beginning, you said that you shouldn't post the same thing in every social network. I don't think so, but sometimes, because of convenience, you know, we can't change everything. Sometimes I do the same in all of them because of convenience. You know, sometimes I do that. I'm not perfect. You also have to be able to readjust and adapt. So it depends. If I was managing your accounts, I wouldn't post the same thing in the same way.
Han ampliado son menos.
You know, one thing is that the characters in Twitter are limited. The formats are limited. It's not the same a format for a story. You have to modify at least the design of the graphics. But I will have to look at your network. What is the one that works the best for you, just out of curiosity?
No, la que más te funciona.
The one that works, not the one that you like the most, the one that works best for you.
Likes.
In regards to likes, Instagram.
La más amable.
Mine too. Instagram is the friendlier one.
Es
Twitter, for example.
Acciones. Yo no ponía viendo
ahí. Is the public plaza for criticizing.
La granja de
you have a lot of trolls. You have a lot of haters.
Cada vez me gusta.
So I'm liking Twitter a lot less.
Depende de para qué.
For companies. But it depends for what.
Comunicación.
When I want to communicate and I want to communicate something a lot faster, I use it a lot more than Instagram. It depends on what you want to use it for.
Sino que es más útil para ti.
But at the professional level, it's not about what you like the most, it's about what works the most for you. In my case, LinkedIn is the one that works the less for me.
Mucha gente contacta conmigo a nivel profesional por
But I have a lot of people that contact me professionally through Instagram and not LinkedIn. Well, then I'm sorry about LinkedIn.
Que es personal.
Hablarle a nuestro público, mirar y analizar.
Talk to your audience. Analyze statistics.
Que las redes sociales,
and to be clear, social media is not a public service.
Luis.
They're companies, and because of that, they have to make money. So organic posts, which are the ones that we do without monetizing them,
con muchísima suerte, al 5%.
They reach maybe 5% of your audience. That's why you have the same contacts, the same likes from everyone. In Facebook, if you think Facebook doesn't work for money, you're wrong. Facebook wants you to spend money, and they will do whatever is possible to reach less and less people organically. We have 3 minutes for a few more questions.
Así que compramos tiempo.
Venga.
Luis, tu pregunta.
Luis, your question.
Sí.
No, excelente conferencia. Gracias.
Excellent conference. Thank you.
Tú hablabas hace un momento de.
You said a little while ago about Macron. He looks to the right. You changed the image of the person.
Y te encanta.
And you love him, I know.
A nivel comunicación, a nivel político, pero bueno, sí, me gusta.
No, pero la pregunta es, okay, una cosa es el cambio de imagen.
So one thing is the change of image.
Tiene su personalidad.
But when you change somebody's image, people have their own personality, right? Even though you change their image.
Porque uno tiene una.
How do you make this change of image to be in accordance to their essence?
Esto no se trata de ponernos a todos un traje y chaqueta.
This is not about, you know, dressing you up. We talk about the physical appearance.
Es lo más curioso, es lo más visual. ¿Os acordáis de?
We talk about changing the image because visually that is what is going to be attractive the most. Yesterday, I posted a picture of Juan. I changed his image. He was using a suit, a jacket. He used to wear very dark colors. He was a loser, and I told him, you are a loser. No one is going to vote for you. Not even your mother is going to vote for you with that image because you look like a loser, and I want a man that I can, you know, that I can give the keys to my house. I need you to generate trust. And because of that, I leveraged his physical appearance. We used other colors that he actually liked. I don't do a custom for anybody because you don't feel comfortable with the changes. It's going to happen the same case as a psychologist that you saw. You are going to have a wonderful image counselor. They're going to change you up. You are going to go in TV programs of radical changes, but then you're going to go back to being you. So we have to work with your essence. I took one shopping with one day with a personal shopper. And with Juan, the big work I did was at an internal level to get to know him and what kind of communication was good for him and for his client, what he was comfortable with, what he was uncomfortable with. It wasn't just appearances. For appearances, for his image, it only took 1.5 days. For the rest of it, we worked for 6 months. And it's such an internal change that now he made it his own. I taught him. And I told him, when you are at a plenary, you need to tell them this and this and this. And when you're working with a syndicate, you need to talk to them in this way. So you teach them. But it takes time. We work with his communication, words that are allowed, words that are prohibited. We quiz them and we tell them, these are things that you can use. These are things that you can never use. These are certain behaviors that you need to have. It's not just a change in image. That is the easiest part, just like changing the logo of a company. When you change a company logo, that is easy, right? And then you have a bill for 40,000 euros just for changing the image or just for changing a color, right? But that brings something behind.
Esto es siempre cuestión de percepción.
And I don't say no to the image because it's all about perception, right?
Y hablamos de que has cambiado una coma y la has puesto en verde en tu logotipo. Y eso significa.
And for example, if you change just one thing in your logo, that means that you are looking into the future and the new area of digitalization. But you need to analyze who you're talking to, and you need to be comfortable with what you are transmitting. If I had to summarize the last comments that you were answering to, the last questions you were answering to, we always go back to the person, the individual, the particular case you're working with, the moment that person is on, and how that person communicates to the world. That is very individual. So you don't have a universal answer because it depends on the personal circumstances of that person or that company. There is not a universal answer.
Sientan delante de vosotros y os van a hacer una comunicación como churros. Yo no la hago, yo hago una comunicación artesanal.
And I do know people that sit in front of you and they tell you the very same generic thing in every case. I don't do that. I don't have 80 customers because I cannot work well with a lot of people. People want you to give them a secret recipe, and I always tell them the same. Treat others the way you want them to treat you. You need to be kind. For the rest of it, you have to analyze. You have to look at tables and data, and I work with my psychologist friends doing data and doing surveys because you have to analyze a lot. And the same recipe is not going to work for everyone. You are going to find professionals in communication that are going to say, well, she doesn't know what she's talking about. But each and every one of us have their own reputation. So, Maria, as closing, we bought a little bit of time, but the time we bought is not eternal. I just wanted to propose to you a very brief game. Let's say that I'm Juan, the politician. Tell me.
Haceme la pregunta o el comentario.
Ask me or make me a comment in real time.
Señor, ya me dijiste perdedor.
Let's pretend that I'm Juan. You already called me a loser, right? So what's next?
Hola, María.
Hello, María. I'm a politician. I want to conquer the masses.
No sé, ser presidente.
I don't know. I want to be the president of a city.
¿Cómo sigue el cuento?
What's next? After you call me a loser, what is next? The first thing, we would have to analyze who you are. And I'd have to tell you that not everybody is worthy for something. Not everybody has to be a leader. I'm sorry, but that's just the truth. There are people that no matter how much they work on, they're not going to be the leader. Everybody has to be in their lane. Everybody has to work on what is good for them. When I talk to big companies and I analyze them, I do a profile of everyone that they have in their team. Sometimes they are very surprised. It's because I find a leader in somebody that is not working at a leadership position.
Remero en alguien que está.
And I find an aide, a helper, in somebody that is in a very big position. So they are very surprised. So each one have to work on their own lane. We are good at something. We're not good at everything, but we are good at something.
Actitudes.
I saw some kind of attitudes and abilities, skills in this person.
Rango X en política porque te gusta.
And I told him, I can maybe get you to a specific position as a politician, but you're not going to go over.
A ti mismo y después pregúntale a María.
Exactamente.
So the answer is know yourself and then ask María.
Damos por
exactly. And with this, we conclude the panel. Thank you, María.